Hello everyone, this is your favorite asshole, Elvis Presley, and I am back reviewing the Huawei Ideos S7 tablet. Now I know it's been out for a minute, but you guys know I'm catching up on all my devices that I have reviewing. I'm actually sitting on my couch, not at my desk, and I'm actually, the irony in this is, I'm recording this with my Motorola Zoom, which replaced this guy, but, I mean, within a month, it replaced him, so he's got to go to bed. Okay. Let's get to the gist of it. This thing could have had a good life. I think what held this device back is the fact that it's touch capacitive. If you notice that you see this, I'm rubbing with my finger, nothing's happening. Like it's not moving. But if you move with your nail, it happens. So, this thing takes forever to boot up, which is why I didn't do, you know, anything specific with it. As you can see, this is the weirdest thing I've ever seen. Look how many screens it has, number one. This is called Emotion, and Emotion is Huawei's, I guess, Motorola blush whiz, you know, quote-unquote, it's their skin they put over Android. Take a look at the back. The back, the cool thing about this is it does come with, oops, I was taking the back off earlier, so excuse me. I'm selling this if you guys want to buy it, too. You see, it comes in the back. I have a T-Mobile SIM card in here. It does work over 3G and Wi-Fi. I do get 3G when I use my T-Mobile. I don't know what everyone else is in. A lot of guys are doing too much, so they don't know what they're talking about. If I'm correct, it's a, what is this? I think it's a 2-megapixel camera, if I'm correct. Yeah, it is. So, yeah, 2-megapixel camera. It has a front, you see, back just clips right on. Bow. There's no flash. So it actually says 2-megapixel right there. You can't see it because this, of course, this camera isn't that great on the zoom. Well, it is, but you get the gist of what I mean. Okay. You have your bottom for your micro SD, and I have no idea what the hell this is. It's not an HDMI, clearly. You have your volume rocker. Your speaker is on the side. Now, this thing, the sound on this is ridiculous. Now, there's your charger port, and there's your micro USB port, and there's the other speaker. Now, these speakers look very small, but, oh, wow, PayPal. Okay, hold on. Okay, there we go. We're going to look at the response of this screen, so let's go. Oh, yeah, also, let me, I can't talk about this. Since they know it's touch capacitive, I mean, excuse me, touch sensitive, not capacitive, they put this little stylus back here. I don't use it. I've learned to use my nail because, see, you can't even get it out. Like, it sucks. Oh. Okay. So, there you go. Okay. So, we're not going to use it, though. I'll use my nail because I'm used to the regular Android experience. I'm not used to anything being touch sensitive anymore. Let's see. So as you see, it's the regular Android dock, though, but the, you know, the launcher, again, is Emotion. Now, Emotion has a cool clock widget. I do like the clock widget. But, okay, it's sectioned off in two screens of home, two screens of web, entertainment, communications, and favorites, which I saw where they were going with it, but it's unnecessary. It's Android. You're doing way too much, dude. Oh, let's talk about this. It does work as a telephone, but you'll be on speakerphone if you talk on it as a telephone. You can just take any SIM and just pop it in here, literally, and it works as a phone. If you want to talk privately, you have to use your headphones. So you have your, of course, there's regular click buttons. Get a nice firm click. You have your back button, your menu button, and your home button. You have your in button, call button. Now this does, this is sweet. They do have a capacitive button on here somewhere. See, you can go through all the screens like that. Now, that's a lot easier. In my month of having this, I've never used it this much. I've never used that button because you just don't find any front-facing camera. The odd thing about this is you can record with it, but there's no applications on Eclair, which is what this is running on. Let's take a look at that also. So let's go down here to settings. And we'll look at about tablet. Firmware 2.1 update 1, Ideos 7. So you see, there's no root or anything for this thing. This thing is like that horrible that people are trying to root it, but I don't know why. I don't think it's worth the time or the effort to even brick this and lose your $299 or $250 that you paid for it. I don't find that it's even worth it. Basically, you say have fancy widgets, you know, have all this stuff. Angry Birds rocks on here, though. You can see the load time on it is good. It has a 1 gig processor in it. So it's up there with the big dogs. Don't get me wrong. This thing can fly. It's not slow by any means. But I'm just doing this for a display because, you know, Angry Birds usually the test to see if your phone sucks. Is there any sound on here? Or did I just turn it off? And you can lay it down because the speakers are on the side. Told you. Let's try this. You see, even though you're tapping it, it's still fast. The clarity is great. Don't get me wrong. This thing is no slouch in that area. This being touch sensitive kills it. That's the only thing that killed it. And being stuck on Eclair 2.1 update 1, it killed it. You know, you can't do much. There's no apps for video or any if you want to use Quick. Tango only uses the back camera. Fring only uses the back camera. That's what sucks. You know, so nothing works with the front camera but if you're regular video recording. Let's take a look at this. Okay, so let's take a look. Yes, I'm that good. See, no lag at all. Even with the 1 gig processor, you shouldn't have any lag anyway. So let's go ahead and get out of here. Ooh, new high score. Wow, that is cool. Pretty much, there's not too much. You guys will probably want to see with this. YouTube, same YouTube. It's the 2.1. Yeah. I didn't connect to my Wi-Fi because I'm about to wipe this thing like as soon as I'm done doing this video, so I can sell them. Cause I don't need them. My Zoom does about everything and everything. And like I say, I'm all for touch capacitive. I can't deal with touch sensitive. As you guys can see, the speed on it is good. And the music player is the standard Android music player. As you can see, I'm in entertainment now. Watch the bottom. As you can see, while I'm scrolling through, it's going through everything. You have your call log, and you actually have the phone dialer, which is made for a phone. But once you turn them upside down, it doesn't do anything, see? So, something else that sucks. Email. I mean, pretty much everything that's standard with Android. That's why I'm not going too in depth with a lot of these things that I review. So I'm just showing you basic. I mean, look at the music player. Standard. It's here because I don't want to play any music because I got in trouble on here. They said I was playing someone else's music on here and they stuck Outkast, even though it was, part of the thing, here. I play something that doesn't belong. It's a friend of mine's song. Pimp C. Off Skrilldilly Day 2. So, www.skrilldilly.com. Yeah. Really cool guy. Let's keep going back. So, basically, you have this is the videos tab. Now, I like this widget. I like some of the emotion widgets. Don't get me wrong. I'm not completely against, emotion, but it's unneeded. A lot of the things are already integrated into Android. I understand you want to make it your own and you want your product to stand out from the others. This is something that bites, dude. Look at this. Okay, let's clear that. Notifications are there. Your task manager is built over here. Problem being, you can't kill any of this stuff. Look, you could try to kill it, but some of it won't close. I've tried to close it and it comes like, look, why is alarm clock stuck open? I don't have an alarm set. Look at that. Okay. Let's kill everything. Damn it. Everything. Let's murder all of you. Okay, bam. So that's all that's left open. So this is the task thing. The task bar is always going to be there. You can't use ADW or Launcher Pro or anything on here because it does not work. You won't be able to access the notifications bar, but pretty much, like I say, everything is standard in here that you find in Android. I mean, you find everything for Amazon MP3. I mean, everything works in here. Anything you can do on your phone, you can basically do on this. I mean, there's nothing that you can't do on this thing that you can't do on your phone because it's basically a huge phone. That's honestly all this thing is. You know, where the Zoom is able to establish itself as, hey, I'm a tablet. This thing is stuck as a phone. that. It's basically a phone, and that's where I'm at with it. It's a damn phone. Your wireless networks, settings, and display. Like I say, everything is in here that's in your phone. So there's no need for me to go into it. Touchscreen calibration. I mean, that's about the only thing they added. But pass or this sucker fails. I mean, because in the end, it doesn't get the job done. When it comes to what I'm looking for in a tablet, it lacks. I mean, as a tablet, there's no tablet. I mean, there's no. This is my thing where I think everyone has failed. Let me show you this. Okay. You see, I'm sitting on the couch. So, this is my couch. You see the couch right there in front of me. Bow. So, you see the couch. I can turn it around front facing. I think you have to hit menu, then hit, yeah, secondary camera. And you see me with the Zune, with the plastic all over it still. You can see the Motorola logo and all that stuff. See? Yeah, this is really hard to do, actually. If I was trying to show you something, how would you do it? Okay, yeah. Well, you see the Zune. See? Motorola, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. See the Motorola logo? Okay. Wow. I'm really plugging a Zoom during my thing. So, as you see, it's the exact same as the regular standard Android camera. The motion's just something that I feel it was rushed. Even on the watch, Huawei has completely failed with emotions launcher and widgets. It's completely freaking useless. You know, I really wanted to say the F word like really bad, but I'm trying to refrain from being a butthole. But pretty much you guys have got this is the gist of it. You see how fast it moves. Everything else, sound is great. You've heard sound. I've showed you the speed of it. The only thing, like I say, is the fact that you have to do this. Look at that. Now that's sweet. That's the only thing that's sweet in here. Now, if I could find a way to integrate that, because right now I'm running fancy widgets on mine. So, pro. And that's just for the clock, because I don't like the little Android analog clock. It's bullshit. But I don't know why they keep putting analog clocks, like anyone really uses the analog clock. Like, seriously, Google. This is 2011, dude. Pretty much that's it, guys. There's nothing else to show you here, literally. There, it does nothing. Oh! I can show you one other thing. Let's show you a movie on here. So you can see that. I know it's gonna die like really fast, so when it dies, I only have like 3 minutes left anyway. Let's go to, I think, here you go, videos. I put, let's see, what we're gonna watch. We're gonna watch Hancock. Listen to the sun. Screen quality's good. Like I say, it's the only thing it failed on. I don't know if I'm gonna get a copyright infringement for showing that either. These guys are so just You play like one piece of something and they want to hit you with a copyright infringement on here. Battery is low, we know. Battery life on here is fairly good. I get roughly about I want to say out of this thing, I get about a good 4 maybe 4 to 6 hours with heavy use. Of course, on my tablet, look at that, it's powering off. Battery, told you guys. On my Zoom, I get about roughly about 7 to 9 with heavy use. I use my thing continuously all day, nonstop. So there we go, guys. Thanks. Elvis Freshly, be back with another review later. I'm gonna do a review on the Zoom features later.